Hello, and in this video, we are going to learn how to put bullet points side by side in Word. So you can see here that I have a very simple list of bullet points. It's only one word per bullet, so there's still a lot of white space on the right. And what we really want to do is to put all the bullet points side by side next to each other in Word. Now, many of us has tried to do this before. We could go to Layout, and then go to Column, and then select two columns. But notice what happens. The whole document will be put into two columns, which is not what we want. We want only the bullet points to be put into two columns. There's one principle that we need to keep in mind is that columns only work for a section, not for a page and not for a list. So in order for Word to understand that we only want our bullet list to be put into two columns, then we would need to put all the bullet list into a separate section and make only that section two columns. But of course, Word is very smart now, so Word will automatically split into different section breaks for us. But in order for Word to do that, we will need to specify the start point and then the end point of our list. So here's what we can do. Select all the list, then go to column, and then select two columns. And that's done. And you can see that if you click on the bullets, let me enlarge this, then it will be on section 2. But if you click on the text below, and then it will be on section 3. If you click on the text above the bullet point, and notice what happened, it will be on section 1. So this means that Word automatically splits the document into three different sections for the bullet points to be working properly the way we want. So remember, in order to put bullet points side by side in Word, instead of placing the mouse cursor anywhere inside the list, we would need to select all the list and then go to Layout, go to Column, and select two columns. This way, it will ensure that the bullets will behave side by side next to each other, but the rest of the document will still be within one column so that it will work properly. And that's it for now. Happy learning, and see you in the next video.